Hi, my name's David, and I'm going to tell you how I manage my incontinence problem. Since I was a kid, I had a condition called urinary incontinence, which means that I don't just wet my bed at night, but also pee my pants during the day. Back in the kindergarten, this happened more often, but it was also much easier to deal with. The kids didn't always understand it was something laughable. If they did pay attention to my mishap, it wasn't for too long. Everyone quickly forgot about it and returned to whatever they were doing. Like every kid, I was looking forward to school, but if I had only known it would bring me nothing but trouble, I would probably find a way out of it. My parents comforted me and said everything would be okay, but it was just words. I had to switch schools several times because of my condition. Whenever school started, it was fine, but as soon as someone scolded me or yelled, the thing happened. I attended the same school for the first 2 years of elementary school. The teachers really cared about us and let us get away with minor failures. I got used to my first teacher, who was calm and kind. Her lessons were always interesting. I was especially fond of math and nature. I only peed myself twice back then. The first time happened after a classmate yelled at me. It was the final lesson of the day, and I stayed at my desk until all other pupils left. The teacher approached me and realized what happened. She said that I shouldn't worry and that it would get better with age. But she came to our home that night to talk to my parents. They were alarmed. They took me to one doctor after another, who prescribed more and more examinations and procedures, even though I was apparently healthy. The second time I embarrassed myself happened during a physical education class. We were doing dip bar pull-ups. All the boys succeeded. Some could do 10 pull-ups, some 15, some 8, and I couldn't even do a single pull-up. I was hanging there on my thin arms while the boys were rolling with laughter. It really hurt. I was about to cry out of frustration, and then I did cry. But in addition to the tears smeared all over my face, a huge puddle was spreading around my feet. My classmates were contemptuous beyond all reason. I wish the earth could swallow me up. In the morning, Mom talked me into going to school, even though I really wanted to refuse. I was so ashamed, I couldn't even bear to imagine the look in everyone's eyes. And I wasn't wrong. As soon as I walked in, the classroom exploded with laughter. The kids spat at me and turned their backs in disdain. Nobody wanted to sit next to me. I barely waited for classes to end to rush back home. And I told my parents I would never attend that school again. It happened once more in a new school though. The reaction was a bit different, but I never forgot the sneering laughter from that other time. I try to control myself at all times to listen to the warning bell, as my psychotherapist used to refer to the urge to urinate. I couldn't listen in class anymore because I had to be listening to myself. And I slipped again. After the school bell rang, I got up from my desk only to see an enormous puddle on the floor. I sat down and didn't dare to move again. It was my deskmate that ratted me out to everyone. The thing happened all over again. The next day I came to a different school wearing a diaper. The day was uneventful. I was accepted by my new classmates and didn't look any different from them. I actually calmed down and got into studying. A few days passed by and failure struck again. One dude noticed my diaper in the locker room and he told everyone. They started bullying and mocking me. I got a lot of questions about my diaper size and changing schedule. I clammed up again. It was terrible. I couldn't get in the mood for studying. One of these days, I straight up refused to go to school. My parents dragged me to a hospital again. I started hypnotherapy with a psychiatrist. I was homeschooled for 2 years. When I got visibly better, the doctor said I could go back to school full time. He expressly forbade wearing a diaper. We selected the new school together as a family. It was far from home, but that wasn't an obstacle. Dad drove me to school. My classmates weren't very friendly at first. They had already bonded with each other and were wary of a newcomer. I was afraid the elementary school incident would repeat, which would be a nightmare for me, especially since there were more girls in my new class. I was high-strung at all times, too scared to go out to the blackboard. I was especially afraid of maths. The teacher was strict and a bit rude. She could easily insult a student and hit them where it hurt. Everyone feared and disliked her. When she reviewed our homework, she would always call a student up to the blackboard and make an example of their mistakes as she explained the correct solution. Woe to anyone who made a mistake. She'd yell, stomp her feet, and she'd explain things, but I never understood any of her explanations through all the yelling. One day, her rage fell upon me. When I heard my name, I flinched. I went up to the board with shaking knees. Naturally, I failed to solve the problem. There she went screaming and yelling. Apparently, I was useless and stupid, and slouches like me ruined the teacher's performance metrics. My head buzzed, pink circles drifted before my eyes, and heat rushed all over my body. I seemed to black out for a minute. When I came to my senses, I was standing in a huge puddle. The teacher had realized her error and was standing there looking embarrassed. The class was dying of laughter. She saw the sneering smiles and realized that it was my last lesson at school. I ran out of the classroom. As soon as I got home, I told my mom I would never set foot in the school again. After consulting my psychiatrist, we made a decision to switch to homeschooling. My mom was my supervising teacher now, and I studied all school subjects remotely. My studies are going well, I am more confident, I do attend classroom lessons occasionally. I've noticed recently I'm not afraid to look into teachers' eyes anymore, and I talk to my peers with ease. So my efforts have not gone in vain. I'm gradually becoming a self-assertive adult. Do you guys want more episodes? Then press the like button, subscribe, and hit the bell. Want to see your own story? Then send them over to this email here,